Hello, success seekers. In the last part of The Alchemist, we discussed that Santiago made good money and those merchants also became rich. So let's dive in into the next part. After 11 months of working, Santiago earned enough money to buy some new ship and return home back. But instead, he decided to take risks and to pursue his dream. After that, Santiago went on a caravan traveling to Egypt. There he met an Englishman who was looking for alchemist. He told him alchemist is someone who can turn lead into gold. When they finally arrived at the Alphaium Oasis, the home of the titular alchemist, Santiago met a girl whose name was Fatima, with whom he instantly fell in love. Now Santiago went to meet her every day on the side of the wall. On the other hand, Englishman reaches the alchemist's place. The alchemist asks the Englishman, "You are searching for me from many years to learn from me, but have you ever tried to turn lead into gold?" The Englishman answers no. Then the alchemist says, "Go and try yourself to turn lead into gold." After that, the Englishman came back and started his work, whereas on the other hand, Santiago decided to stay at Oasis with Fatima and not pursue his dream. But the alchemist and Fatima convinced him to pursue his dream, and Fatima told him that she will wait for him. After that, once again, Santiago started his journey. While in his further journey, Santiago faced many challenges. But in that journey, Santiago learned lots of trainings from the old man, the alchemist, the Englishman, merchant, desert, and from many things. After facing all those challenges in his journey, he finally reached the Egyptian pyramid, which he saw in his dream. Now Santiago was very happy because he finally reached Egyptian pyramid. After that, he started digging in the place he had dreamed of. But again, the thieves came, grabbed him, and beat him continuously. When he told about his dream to one of the thief came and laughed at him and said, "I had exact same dream, except in my dream, it told me to go to an abandoned church in Spain, where shepherds often took their sheep to rest and where the treasures are buried. But I am not the foolish person like you, who will go that far to pursue my dream." After that, they left Santiago and returned from there. But Santiago was very happy because he finally understood where his treasure was. The treasure was in Spain, under the sycamore tree where he had his original dream. After Santiago returned to Spain and found his real treasure, then he gave 1/10 of his treasure to that woman whom he promised, and he returned back to Alphaium and he happily lived with Fatima. Here the story ends. Some of the best lessons we get to learn from this book are: lesson number 1. Always listen to your heart. The lesson teaches us that not to worry about what other people think of our dream. It doesn't matter whether it looks bad or small for them. We always need to do the things what we really like from the bottom of our heart and do not do what others told us to do. Just like Santiago, instead of becoming a priest, he chose to be a shepherd because he listened to his heart. So always listen to your heart. Lesson number 2. Don't be afraid to be failed, because without failure nothing can be achieved in this world. Some of the greatest invention happened after hundreds of failure. Imagine if they were scared, if they said that they will not do that a second time just because they were afraid of being failed again. We would have never got to see big invention today. It's because of their failure and continuous action we are able to use everything what we have today. Only thing that keeps you away from achieving your goal is the fear of failure. So conquer the fear of failure and achieve what you want. Just like we never give a birth to a baby in 1 month, we will never get success in 1 day. It always takes time. Lesson number 3. Love. True love is something which holds you back, but not that which supports you, just like Fatima. Instead of holding back Santiago, she supported him to pursue his dream. Lesson number 4. Real treasure. The real treasure was not the treasures that Santiago found buried in the church. Rather, the real treasure were the lessons he learned, the personal growth he had, and experience he had in search of his personal legend. If he found his treasure easily, then he would have never learned many things, because only knowledge and experience gives you the most value in life, which I also said in previous video, Lessons from Aankho Dekhi. If you don't fail, how can you learn? And if you don't learn, how can you grow? So never be afraid to fail and keep seeking success. I shared all the useful information from The Alchemist by Paulo Coelho. If you find this video useful, then like, subscribe and share with your family and friends. And don't forget to subscribe my channel so I can make this kind of useful videos in the future. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned, stay safe, and keep seeking success. Goodbye.